Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain examples based on delta modulation. So you can see my previous sessions where I have already explained everything regarding delta modulation. So now in this session onwards, we'll be solving examples based on delta modulation. So see, in this first problem, a delta modulation system is designed to operate at sampling frequency of 6 kHz. So let us note down all those data which is given here. Sampling frequency FS, that is 6 kHz. And step size is 350 millivolt. So step size delta, that is 350 millivolt. Now see, first question, that is determine the maximum amplitude of a 1 kHz input sinusoidal signal for which delta modulation does not show the slope overload. So here, maximum amplitude of 1 kHz input sinusoidal signal is given. So it means modulating signal frequency, that is 1 kHz, that is given. So here we are deliberate to identify what should be the maximum amplitude so that slope overload distortion will not happen. So, to avoid slope overload distortion, we have already derived this condition, A of AM, that should be less than or equal to delta by 2 pi FM TS. So, here all the data that is given, so let us have those datas. Delta is equals to 350 millivolt. So 350 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 2 pi. FM is 1 kilowatt. So 10 to the power 3. And TS is what? 1 by FS. So this is what? 1 divided by means it will be in numerator 6 kilowatt. So 6 into 10 to the power 3. So if you calculate this value, you will be finding this is 0.3357 volt. So to avoid this slope overload, this AM, that should be lower than this voltage. Now over here, second question, that is determine output SNR. Now see, output SNR of delta modulation. So that even we have derived it in previous session. You just see that I have derived it by 3 divided by 8 pi square FM square TS cube W, where W is bandwidth. Now here all the data that we have, but we don't have W. So let us calculate W first. So we have FS. So based on FS sampling rate, we can have bandwidth W. So FS is equals to 2W. So W is equals to FS by 2. FS is 6 kHz divided by 2. It means it will be 3 kHz. So now W is equals to 3 kHz. So place all those data here. So SNR will be 3 divided by 8 pi square FM, that is 1 kHz. So 10 to the power 3 square TS, that is actually 1 by FS. So this will be 1 by FS, that is 6 kilo means 10 to the power 3 and whole cube into W that we have calculated, it is 3 kHz. So place that 3 kHz. So let us re-simplify this. So 3 into 6 cube into 10 to the power 9, that is this term. So this will come in numerator, that's why. Divide by 8 pi square into this will be 10 to the power 6 into this will be 3 into 10 to the power 3. So if you solve this, you'll be finding this value will be 2.77 somewhat, right? So this value will be somewhat this. And to calculate this in dB, you just do 10 log of 2.77. And if you calculate this, then this SNR that you will be obtaining in terms of dB by 4.42 dB. So this is magnitude and this is in terms of dB. So this will be our SNR. So I hope that you have understood this. I'm not solving that by calculator here. You just do it in Calci, you will be finding this. Let us move on to next problem. So see, in this problem, consider analog input signal and that is having x of t that is equals to 0.1 sine of 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 t. So let us mention all those data which is given. X of t that is 0.1 into sine of 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 t. For a delta modulation system, the signal is sampled at a rate of 2 into 10 to the power 4 hertz. So here fs is given, that is 2 into 10 to the power 4 hertz. Find out whether the slope overload distortion will occur for the following step size. First step size is delta is equals to 4 millivolt and second step size, that is delta is equals to 60 millivolt. So we will be checking this for both of this delta. So first of all, what is that condition? So to avoid slope overload distortion, condition is delta by TS, or one can say delta into FS, that should be greater than or equal to dxt by dt of max. Means if this value is greater than this, then we can avoid slope overload distortion. Now see, first what we will be doing is, we will be checking it for delta of TS, delta of F of S, right? So for both of the cases, and then we will be comparing it with this. So let us calculate dxt by dt of max. So let us calculate RHS first. So RHS, that is dxt by dt of max. So this is what exactly, d by dt of x of t, that is this. So just place this 0.1 into sine of 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 t. And we want this with maximum value. So this will be 0.1 and this differentiation will be into 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 cos of 2 pi into 10 to the power 4 t. And we want maximum value of this. So to have a maximum value, cos of theta, that should be 1. So this will be 1 to get maximum value. So if you calculate this, this will be 2 pi into 10 to the power 3. So this is what our RHS. Now we'll be calculating first condition with delta is equals to 4 millivolt. So 4 delta is equals to 4 millivolt. We just need to check it, this condition, delta FS. LHS, that is, let us say it is delta 1. So delta 1 FS. So delta 1 is 4 milli, means 10 to the power minus 3, into FS, that is given 2 into 10 to the power 4. So you'll be finding this is 4 into 2, 8 into 10. 4 into 2 into 10. So that has to be 80. And this should be greater than RHS. Condition is what? This should be greater than RHS. So this LHS, that is what exactly lower than this value. It is what? Lower than 2 pi into 10 to the power 3. It means slope overload will occur with delta 1 is equals to 4 millivolt. Now let us do this same calculation for second case, and that is delta is equals to 60 millivolt. So 4 delta 2, that is 60 millivolt. Let us have LHS. So that is delta 2 FS. So delta 2, that is 60 milli 10 to the power minus 3. FS, that is 2 into 10 to the power 4. So this is 120 into 10, that is actually 1200. Now you can see that is even lower than this value, which is what even lower than RHS. So one can say this is even lower than 2 pi into 10 to the power 3. It means again there will be slope overload. So one can say slope overload will occur with delta 2, that is equals to 60 millivolt. So this is what the case which is happening with both of the cases. So I think you should understand one thing: to avoid slope overload, this is the basic condition, delta by TS, or one can say delta FS, that should be greater than rate of change of signal with respect to time with its maximum value. So this is the condition to avoid slope overload distortion. And we have checked it for both of the cases. I hope that you have understood it. Let us have one more problem, so it will give you more clear idea about delta modulation problems. Now see, in this question, linear delta modulation is designed to operate a speech signal which is limited to 3.2 kilohertz. Means here bandwidth is limited to 3.2 kilohertz. Let us mention it. W is equals to 3.2 kilohertz. The delta modulation uses following specifications, where sampling rate, that is what 10 times of Nyquist rate. So here sampling rate F of S, that is 10 times of Nyquist rate. So what is Nyquist rate? So Nyquist rate, that is what, twice times of bandwidth. So Nyquist rate, that is what, twice times of bandwidth. And here bandwidth is 3.2, so that will be 20 into 3.2 kilohertz. So it means that has to be 64 kilohertz. So sampling rate, that is what, 10 times of Nyquist rate, that is given. So Nyquist rate is twice times of bandwidth. And if you place it, so you will result into FS is equals to 64 kilohertz. And step size is given 100 millivolt. So delta is even given 100 millivolt. So here question is, the modulator is tested with 1 kilohertz sinusoidal signal. It means here we are testing this with FM is equals to 1 kilohertz. Determine the maximum amplitude of test signal required to avoid slope overload distortion. So we are dealing with to calculate AM, which is required to avoid slope overload distortion. So we already know, to avoid slope overload, all we need to satisfy is AM, that should be lower than or equal to delta divided by 2 pi FM TS. Now we have every data. You can even say this is what, one can replace it, TS can go in numerator, so it could be delta F of S divided by 2 pi FM. So this is the basic condition, right? Now place values. We have all values. Delta, that is 100 milli. F of S, that is 64 kilo. Divided by 2 pi into FM. FM is 1 kilohertz. So if you solve this, you'll be finding this value is 1.02 voltage. So this AM, that should be lower than this value, 1.02 voltage. Then only we can avoid slope overload distortion. So this is how we can solve basic problems regarding delta modulation. I hope that you have understood this. And even you can place queries if you have any in comments. Definitely we will be having discussion and I will try to resolve those. Thank you so much for watching this video.